the moments building up to it, we're playing like Nuck If You Buck on the speakers. Teyonah comes over because she hears the music and everybody getting crunk. We kind of don't even want to say action right now. It's like a party. And we stop the music, it's like action. And then they just like start like tearing it up. Growing up, I didn't know anybody who was a filmmaker. I had literally no idea how movies were made. And it wasn't until I got to college as an art student who wasn't very good at art. I actually kind of tripped and stumbled into a film project for one of my art classes. That was the only time where I felt like I had the coldest project in the class. I was like, oh, there might be something there. I didn't think I would get into any film schools because I had no formal training. And I was like, oh, I might as well just apply. And it was when I got to USC that I really started to take it seriously. You know, it was like, maybe I could do it. It was really me and Tony, man, my producing partner, writing partner. Like, what we did when we graduated was just make it a point to like start writing stuff.
That's okay. That's the mark shit.
Okay. The hardest thing to do when you leave school is to actually like sit down and do stuff, because there's no like threat. If you don't turn in a script to a writing class, the threat is you get a bad grade and, you know, yada, yada, yada. But you don't write outside of it, and nothing really gonna happen to you. So we used all of the fellowships and the festivals as artificial deadlines, most of which we didn't even get accepted to, but we just used them as excuses to write different things. Just do the reps and get the material. We wrote like 5 or 6 scripts in like 4 or 5 months. Tyrone is an idea that I had, but I thought it was like too ambitious. I thought that there was a chance that we could sell this idea, but I didn't think that there was a chance that they would let me direct it. It was some really close friends of mine. They were like, yo, like, you need to pitch this for yourself. You're talking with the actors about what feels natural, what makes sense for the story. Just maintaining the tone, just balance the satire with the drama of what we were going for collectively. You know, I had a professor, shout out Barnett Kelman. He would always say, do no harm. And I was trying to keep that in my mind, like, just get out their way. When you get on set, you're like, oh, shit. Yeah, let me get out the way, you know what I mean? And let them do their thing. They're so talented.
If you could pour me to the elevator that leads down to the Fiki Laboratory, I'd be out your atmosphere.
When it comes to, like, just maintaining the tone and being able to like just balance the satire with the drama. We really let them kind of take the reins and take control of their characters.
Right now, let a motherfucker try me.
Even though I was, you know, a co-writer on the script, like I was completely open to improv. There's a lot of dense dialogue in certain areas. They brought a lot of the banter to life.
That's what's gonna kill you, you know? His name is Curiosity. His name is Curiosity. That's what's gonna kill you. Curiosity kills
you. You're sucking up all the air in here. Damn.
Jamie would throw all kind of stuff, you know. Like, I would have one line, a scripted line, and I'm like, you do it. Any art you want.
Little beige, my f-. You mixed? Steph Curry? You one of them Curry boys?
Got that tapioca skin, huh?
A lot of time, if someone's like directly like insulting somebody, it's just off the dome.
Did they hit you back about your resume? And how about that novel you write? What chapter is you on? 69?
Kiss my ass.
They would take things that are scripted and make them sound better. The approach was, please help us at every turn. Please help make us look as good as you can help us. It's a mystery movie first and foremost, but you know, obviously there's comedy, there's a little sprinkle of science fiction. You know, it has a blaxploitation patina. It's definitely a bootleg Scooby-Doo movie. It is so, genre works so well. To talk about such a broad spectrum of things gives you a nice amount of distance between the audience and like what it is that, you know, you want them to receive.
Everywhere else?
Oh.
Everywhere my else, get it.
Oh, look at the pinky.
Goddamn right.
The pinky.
You got a chance of it working if the actors are great. Teyonah, Jamie, John, Kiefer, David Allen Greer, they were super instrumental, you know, in being able to ride these different tones. As long as the characters feel real and grounded, you can kind of go wherever you want to go.
I'm tired.
I don't know who I am no more.
The hardest scene was the strip club scene. And the script is just set in a club. We're thinking like 200 extras, body to body, sardine. You can barely move.
Yeah, sit down. Come on.
That's kind of where the tension is supposed to come from. But because of COVID, when we shot it, we changed it to a strip club so that you can use the stage and like certain things to like take up floor space and reduce the amount of people that you needed. Now you have to block it in a way because you can only shoot a very small burst. So we only had 65 backgrounds that you could use. They could fill up like a quarter of the room, and you need them to change clothes, and like each person has to be two or three different people. As soon as you get here, you have to reset and then slide everybody this way, change clothes, slide over here. And then of course, you try to do this in one day.
Well, let's get it, man.
When they destroyed the lab at the end, that one is like burned in my memory because we only got one take to do it. When they destroy this set, there's gonna be no second take, so it gotta look good. We had all these scientists in lab coats and people with baseball bats. We've like walked through very slowly, like the choreography. It's a dolly move. They're like catching different pieces of action. The moments building up to it, we're playing like Nuck If You Buck on the speakers. Teyonah comes over because she hears the music. She started getting caught, and I'm running around to everybody in the lab coat. Don't let them catch you. Don't get caught. You better not get caught. They're getting crunk, and then we stop. The music is like action, and then they just like start like tearing it up. As soon as we say yell cut, they turn the music back on. You know? For me personally, I never thought that anybody would say yes to me. Honestly, for a first time filmmaker, don't be afraid to like put your intentions out in the universe. Putting it out in the universe for others, but your actions start to align with that, you know? So you start just doing things to try to get it made in earnest.